Shalom, friends. It's me, Matt Charnay, the Jewish Life and Interfaith Outreach Coordinator for the Religious Diversity and Pastoral Care Office here at DePaul University. And I'm here with a few tips to make your Zoom Seder awesome. Hooray! If we look outside, we can tell spring is here. The weather is changing. People are outside, moving around. Shorts are on, jackets are off, masks are on. But things are starting to bloom. And with the season of spring, we invite in the holiday of Passover. And I know we had an interesting holiday, Passover holiday last year, and I think this is going to be the last one. I know the light at the end of the tunnel seems to be rapidly approaching, but we have one more Passover holiday in this weird Zoom world. So let's use the things we've learned this year to make this time the best it can possibly be. So a few tips to make your Zoom Seder awesome. Number one, it is all about asking questions. That's what this holiday is all about. That's what the Passover Seder represents, is an opportunity to sit, talk, and ask questions. So we've all become Zoom experts over the last year. I say use those expertise. Use Zoom polls, use the whiteboard, anything that we've been using in our jobs the last year, let's use it for the Passover Seder. Let's utilize those things that we've all had to do over the last year and make it fun. So do a little forethought, think of some questions to ask, some poll questions to ask your family and friends, maybe even go to a breakout room for some specific dialogue during parts of the Seder. Number two, why is this night different than all other nights? We ask this question so many times during the Seder and we get so many different answers, but I encourage you to make this night different for yourself. Make this Zoom situation different for yourself. Make this time holy and sacred. Sacred literally means set apart. So put your Zoom Seder somewhere other than where you do your Zoom work or where you do your Zoom class. I say move your Passover Seder to the comfortable space on the couch. We're supposed to be relaxing anyway. Take it to a different part of your room. Hang something new behind you. Change the space up. Make it holy. Make it sacred. Make it special for you and your family. No reason to sit in the same old, when it's supposed to be a night of differences. Number three, all who are hungry may come and eat. The charge of the Passover Seder, we invite, we open our doors. We say anyone and everyone may come and join. And so I encourage you to do just that. If you're still on Zoom, I say invite someone new. Invite a friend, a colleague, a coworker, someone who's never been to a Passover Seder before. Invite them to your Zoom call. Give them a little what's up before they get on, or maybe just let them experience it all for the first time. If you're in person, keep social distance, keep your space and keep it safe. But again, invite someone who's never been. Invite someone who's looking for a space. Invite someone that you know might need that community, might need that special nefesh boost, that soul boost of being invited to a Seder. Be that person and invite them in. And also go somewhere new. If you're stuck at home and you're doing a Seder again on Zoom, I say second night Seder, go somewhere different, right? Go to the shul that you've always wanted to visit, or go to the temple in another state or another country that you've always heard of. Make it fun and interesting. Why not? This is the year that we get to explore a little bit more. Number four, connect through taste. This is a tactile experience. It's all about seeing, hearing, smelling, touching, tasting, and feeling the history of Passover. So use the tastes to help that connection. I say share a recipe. Maybe you can everyone who's taking part in the Seder can make the same thing, so we're all tasting the same things at the same time. Or if we're keeping it simple, order the same things. Even if you can't order from the same restaurant, order something similar so we're all kind of using the same taste to bring us all together. Or if we're kind of prepping our own thing, I say use the prep time as that time to come together. So if we're making, you know, matzo ball soup before the Seder even begins, why don't you make a quick Zoom call to just make the matzo ball soup via Zoom or a FaceTime, or even just call someone on the phone while you're prepping that meal. Use the meal and the food itself as another way to just bring everyone together. And lastly, I say next year in health. Take a breath. Understand that this is a crazy moment and that this is still the moment of this holiday. And let's try to live into the craziness and the special sanctity that is this interesting Meshugas, absolutely nuts Passover that we're all living in this year. 2021 Passover, everyone. Well, from all of us here at DePaul Jewish Life and everyone at DePaul University, we wish you everyone a Chag Sameach and a happy Passover, happy spring holiday, everybody. Come check out DePaul Jewish Life for more tips and tricks on Jewish communal living. And I wish everyone Shabbat Shalom and Chag Sameach. Happy Passover, everyone.